इट्स टाइम टू से गुड बाय टू थॉर इन बॉम्बे. आई एम टेकिंग हिम विद मी टू गोवा. मैं तोरु बाय मफू बाय मफू. Yeah, that is inside the bag.
Oh!
So that's the car. That's green lightning for everyone who's not seen her. The Porsche is all ready to go to Goa on this trip with me. That's all that I have. That's the only bags. So hey guys, welcome to my channel. Yes, this is my journey to Goa with Thor. Of course, you can see Thor right here. So Thor is right there with me. And he's going to be with me throughout this journey. Yes, this was my plan actually, to take Thor with me to Goa. But unfortunately, I could not do that. So that is him coming with me spiritually and enjoying this journey with me to Goa. So guys, stay tuned for all this fun. It is 3:05 and we are on time. I would plan to actually leave at 3-5 minutes here and there is always okay. Wish me best of luck on this journey to Goa. That's my Thoru baby with me on my phone as well, and we're ready to take off. Sai Baba. Dog zoo, move one side. Bye, little ones. So we have almost reached the Katraj tunnel. You'll see it. It's 1400 meters and here we enter it. I've loved this ride today. So again, in the tunnel there's a maximum speed of 80. We're going to keep and maintain that. I'm sitting at around 62 at the moment. Now 70. 70 is what I've touched right now. But it's a pleasant ride. I prefer doing morning rides. I'm a morning ride person. Even when I was doing my ride to Goa with the bike with Leila, we left exactly sharp at 3. Now my target is to the Satara Ghat before 7ish, before sunrise. Is because there's one spot that I always do my breakfast. If you've not seen my vlog that I did my with Leila, where we took 10 hours to Goa, I'll put it up on the right now. You will see a link. Go ahead and check that video out. It was a beautiful ride as well. That was in November 14-15ish, and this is a ride with green lightning. So very good morning again. Yes, we have reached almost, we've crossed the Pune highway at the moment. Well, my fast tag was not working, but I was charged 270, the regular toll. When I asked the guy, fast tag nahi chal raha, he said fast tag ka 540. I didn't understand that funda. So I'm right now at a petrol pump just after the the express way. And yes, the ride has been beautiful. The only best benefit that I feel right now is with having the surveillance cameras on the road, everyone is maintaining their speed limit. So you don't have everyone, like initially what used to happen, you should have cars ramming front and back and you know, racing, there used to be a race kind of. But this time there is nothing sort of that, because again there's all surveillance cameras. I crossed the Vashi toll at around 3:30 and I was on the Pune Express Highway at 3:47. And right now it is 4:16 and we've crossed the first actually league of the Pune Highway. We've now stopped at the food hall that comes in very close to Pune. So we have just filled the first fueling up, that is 29.79 liters with a rate of 97.37, and we have put 2900 in. So yes, that's pretty much it. So now we're gonna go ahead and continue our journey to Goa on... Thank you. Oh, thank you. So perfect, we are all ready to go. So right now what I'm going to do is I'm actually have the fast tag which is not yet activated. I was thinking that it would be activated as the HDFC girl told me it should be activated within 2 to 24 hours, but then I called the toll free number for the fast tag by HDFC and they told me it will be only activated after 3 days. So it's now time to go ahead and stick it up. I'm going to go ahead and show you how we stick it up as well. So the toilets over here are actually clean. Yes, Abunai? That is, I didn't expect the transportation over here to be so clean. I mean, the toilets should be clean. But yes, if you're traveling with family or with kids, this is one good reason that you have to use the washrooms as well. It's not like before where you used to have stinky and dirty toilets. So the toilets over here are pretty much clean now. So we have Green Lightning right there, she's right there and we're almost ready. I've wasted approximately 10 minutes over here, but yes, it's time to actually take the bike and kick off. Sorry, not bike, the car. Lights on, seat belts fastened. Let's go ahead and put the seat belts on. And we are ready to take off. So I'll catch you later once the sun rises. Because it's a little bit dark, you won't be able to see the road much. But stay tuned for this journey from Mumbai to Goa with Green Lightning and with Thor. So I have finally finished my breakfast. Of course, I had the poa and the chai ki chuski. I love tea in the morning. So we're going to go ahead and carry on this journey to Goa. I should be in Kolhapur by at least 10 is my target. And let's see if I be at Kolhapur at 10. I'll show you a very important person who's with me in the car. He's right here. My Thoru boy. He's also wearing his belt. So it's time to push back. Getting my glasses ready for the sun is the most important thing at the moment. So my co-pilot is there, but he's a little quiet. So my co-pilot is Thor, as you know. He's a little quiet. Otherwise, it's all fine. So we're all set for the takeoff. Let's go ahead. Back onto the roads. Safety should always be first. Your first priority should be safety. Yes. Now I'm full and I'm gonna go ahead and do this ride for at least another 2 or 3 hours continuous. The sun is up, the sun is up. Of course, you might have enjoyed the time lapse I was trying to get while I was driving through the day. It actually brought a very good sunrise. I could not show you the sunrise actually, but you know, we could actually visually get the effect of by the road. The way the road was changing colors, or the sky was changing colors, and how the day actually brightened up. Well, I'm enjoying this ride right now. The best thing what I would like to share with you guys is, yes, the reason I do this early morning rides, because many of my co-workers as well, my manager Sunny, if you're watching this, thank you so much for your wishes. Yes, most of them were telling me, why are you doing an early morning ride? But I prefer doing that. It's only because I've done once in my life, I did a mistake of doing a late night ride. That's when I left at around 9 o'clock from Goa with my sister coming to Bombay. And at 2 o'clock when we were near Nepani, I fell asleep. And me and my sister went 9 feet down with the car. Trust me, if my mom is watching this, she didn't know this till now. So we actually fell into, we went off-road. And lucky that it was not, you know, a ghat or anything like that. We actually went into a field. And that ordeal for that day was basically, I was trying to go ahead and look out for someone to help me and my sister, because my sister was sleeping. She was the co-pilot and she was sleeping. And unfortunately, this thing happened. So we were trying to actually get hold of someone, and then we seen an ST bus come from front, and a small 800, a Maruti 800 as well. And we stopped the car. We stopped the bus and the car. We were lucky enough that you know, the people from the bus, there were a few guys from the bus, and there was approximately four men in the car as well, who helped us remove the car. And trust me, there was not even a scratch to the car. I'm not sure how, but God actually was with me and my sister. If not, that day my parents would lose both their children together. So from that day, I caught my ears saying that, you know, never I'm going to do a late night drive. All my rides, if you have seen previously as well, will always be early morning rides. I prefer to leave the house at 3 o'clock. My last vlog, as you have seen it as well, initially in the video as well, I put an I button. That was basically with Laila, where we touched Goa within 10 hours. Now with Green Lightning, let me see how many hours we're going to touch. And yes, I'm not going to be at, I don't want to be, you know, like they say, speed thrills, but speed can also kill. So I don't want to do that mistake. Of course, I have a lot of people who love me. I'm sure most of you also love me from there, from the screens. And this is me saying thank you so much for, you know, this journey. I would slowly be touching 3,000 subscribers. That's not because of my vlogs or for anything, but it's because of all you guys who support me. Well, this is Mumbaikar boy on his journey to Goa. And of course, Salim bhai, I tried the chai ki chuski for you. If you're watching this vlog, a big salute to you, and good luck for your Xpulse 200. To many more rides. Hopefully I should do a ride with you one day. Let's see if work permits. Till then, stay tuned guys, enjoy this ride virtually with me to Goa. So it says COVID checkpost Kagoli to enter Karnataka, COVID-19 RT-PCR negative medical survey required here. Goa la Goa. Goa, I said, and they didn't check my temperature, nothing. Oh my God. Goa is so free. Can you imagine?
I thought now they will ask me for the RT-PCR test and everything, but I said go and they're like, ja. Oh my God. God save me.
Right now I'm at family hotel Goa West. This is the same place that I always stop because from here we need to take a right into Nepani. And here 10 o'clock, that means I have another 3 hours to go and I should be in Goa by 1 o'clock. So let's see how the road ahead is, because Nepani was a little a rough patch, but otherwise it's going to be a beautiful ride. Yes, it is sunny a little. It is sunny. Of course, it's only because the sun is right bright on top. And it is 10 o'clock. I have not felt the heat. Of course, it was the best climate to actually ride during the early morning hours. And now it's going to be that time where you need to actually put on the AC and drive the car. It's only because the heat will start killing you now. But let's see, I'm going towards the Ghat. So the Ghat area should be much cooler than actually the normal road, because it's much more higher, on a higher level and altitude. So that's it. I just stopped for 5 minutes just to take a breather and to stretch my legs, and I'm done. So I should be headed back to the road soon. So this is the spot where the waterfall is. I don't want to stop, but let's try and get you a sneak peek of the waterfall. The very, very dangerous friends over here are the monkeys. So I'm not going to put my camera and try to give you shots or something. They might just snatch the camera and run away, and then I'll be crying. So this is a waterfall over here on the right. You can see it. It's all dried up at the moment. That's the waterfall. So there's nothing much. Go ahead and see that vlog. You'll get a lot to see. And you can see monkeys all over.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine. So, Nana,